Square Enix presents an Airtight Games production, Quantum Conundrum. Hello, everyone. My name is Stephen George. I play video games, and every Friday, it's a demo. Today's demo is going to be Quantum Conundrum because so many of you wouldn't shut up about it. But hey, if you keep talking, apparently I get the message. So let's take a look at the options before we jump into this, shall we? Controls, which I'm sure they'll probably explain to us, but I love seeing a little sheet before I actually begin. Reverse gravity, heavy, slow-mo, fluffy, dear God, what the heck am I getting myself into? Now, to be honest, I don't actually know a whole lot about Quantum Conundrum. I remember seeing early stuff about it, maybe 2 years ago at E3, and I'm not even sure if that's where I saw it. I might have just seen it like posted on Kotaku somewhere, but it was a long time ago before it even had a name, and I wasn't really sure what it was about. But apparently, it's out! And a lot of people have been talking about it. And like I said before, you guys have wanted me to try it out, so I'm going to try it out.
You must be interested in some good old dimensional problem solving. Well, in that case, you're playing the right trial. Here is some pertinent information that you will need for the next several minutes.
Okay. Move around with left stick, look with right. Okay, pretty standard.
In case you are wondering, I am Professor Fitz Quadrangle, and you just so happen to be in my house.
Use button with X. Assuming I can open the door, hit a button. Button. There we go.
Fine. Now you can go.
Interesting.
That's a very sophisticated invention of mine. A drinking bird. It presses buttons. In this instance, it presses the button that triggers a dimensional shift. Wait for it. Fluffy dimension.
Interesting.
It's adorable, right? Well, it's also useful, as everything is now 10 times lighter.
Including me? Maybe, I don't know. Let's see. So I can actually move this safe and you climb up there. Got it. There we go. Woo, I'm climbing! Okay, pretty straightforward.
Though that looks like a regular scale, it is in fact a portable kinetic mass to electricity converter.
And then it'll close the door? Yeah. Okay, cool. Interesting. Yeah, this is starting to come back to me. I remember watching some videos about this early on, probably maybe 1 or 2 years ago, and it looked interesting. It's nice to see it finally come together and be polished. Can I pick up this lamp? Yes, I can! I love lamp. Okay.
You're now wearing an interdimensional shift glove, or IDS glove. This will soon enable you to shift dimensions on your own.
Okay.
Also, because you are wearing an IDS glove, dimensionality will not apply to you on shifting, and you will remain the same shape, mass, and speed. Oh, lucky you!
Okay, so I got this thing. I don't know what this thing is. I'm assuming it goes here, and then the drinky bird goes there. There we go. Opens it up, get through the door. Cool. And now we're gonna have to do more climbing. I understand the whole concept of fluffy dimension means I can pick up the safe. They don't have to keep shoving it down my throat. I get it. Whee! Okay, so now I'm onward to the next room. Throw the battery into the receptacle mounted on the wall.
That cylinder is an IDS battery, and it powers dimensional shifts. Toss it into the large receptacle mounted on the wall, over there on the second story.
Okay.
That receptacle will distribute the power source around the room, allowing you to now use your IDS device to switch dimensions at your leisure.
Okay. So I can switch to and from with the trigger now. Neato. So I'm assuming I do this. Cool. So now the question to me is that just this room, or is it going to be like that even in the next room?
So you've gotten a taste of fluffy dimension, and you've seen the IDS battery that enables you to switch to it.
Correct. But I guess now I don't get to keep that ability.
Now it's time for you to find out about a whole new dimension in this next room.
Okay, use. Okay, so now I guess things are going to be heavy. Interesting. Start by putting this thing in here. There we go. So we can turn things fluffy. Whee! Boing.
This is a new battery that powers a completely different dimension. Go ahead and put it into the receptacle.
So now I can go to heavy.
Heavy dimension! Rather than objects being lighter than normal, they are now substantially heavier.
Just thought that'd be fun. So I can't even pick up whatever the crap this is. Let's go to normal. So this is just a box. If I switch to heavy, it becomes a huge weight. So I can use that to weigh it down. Interesting. Pretty cool. I like this. Okay, GLaDOS is here. The piss is that? What's it spitting? Boxes? Okay, so it's shooting it. The, what is that? The poop laser 9000? So there's a few of you that'll get that joke, but it's pretty obscure. What is this? Some kind of liquid? I don't know if switching dimensions is going to make that liquid do anything. Let's just walk up here because I broke a window. Gets me through to the other side, and okay, I think I probably, oh, it's, yeah, I probably have to throw it, and as soon as I pick it up, it's reminding me of that, so, pretty cool, I like this is pretty clever, better than I was expecting, honestly.
You know what I miss? Keytars. They always make music so much better. But I digress. This next area is rather interesting.
Okay. Open sesame. Oh. Or hit X. Oh. Interesting.
I would watch yourself around those laser beams. They don't exactly tickle.
Okay, I can make things heavy. There's a button.
Nice job. No, not really. With the increased density and higher melting points of items in heavy dimension, quadrangle laser beams are rendered rather ineffectual.
I see this. Okay. So, should I just disintegrate it? Well, I already did, so can't go back now. I'm gonna keep moving forward. Another button. Button does what? Okay. Interesting. So, okay, it's almost as if I have to make a stairway out of those. And this will be the easiest way to do it, I guess. Oh, I get it. And now I wonder if it's going to continue to try to do that. Yes? No? You're going to keep shooting at it or not? Yes? No? Okay, I guess not. I don't think I can actually move those things. Okay, hold on. Let's do this again.
Like most things in life, timing is key.
Yeah, dude. Timing, like, ridiculous amounts of timing. Oh my god. Okay, so like, I need to like... Oh, fart. Piss! Okay. I get it, but this is really... when he says timing, he's not kidding. Okay, I need to let it hit the first one. 2, 3, don't do it. Don't do it. Oh god, no, oh piss! Oh, you mother... Okay, one more time, got this. This is really hard. One. There we go. Got it. Okay, sweet. Whew, I was a little worried there for a minute. Since I'm not affected, my mass and speed and such, I can just leave it in heavy mode. And use these as stepping stools. There we go.
And oh, that creature there is an interdimensional kinetic entity, or Ike.
What's up, Ike? Hello. Well, at least the game doesn't take itself too seriously, which is fun. Let's throw that in there. So now I have cloud mode, fluffy mode. And what do we have over here? What's up, bro?
Ah, that's where that got to. That is a botched experiment of mine called the Awkward Noise Generator. There's got to be more around here somewhere.
All right. I just got to figure out how to exit this room. There might be a scale of some sort. That's what I'm guessing. The scale would make the most sense because I can now go to fluffy mode and drag those things around. Thanks. What the crap? Safes. Dear God, I couldn't think of the word safe. That's terrible. Alright, so this is fluffy mode. So I'm just gonna grab this. And in fluffy mode, it'll probably disintegrate. But if I just do, like, this, that worked pretty well. Cool. And I'm onward. Open door. Let's get on with it.
I'm not sure if you understand the sheer brilliance that went into creating a device like the one you're using.
Tell me more. Okay, these things don't do anything. Nope.
Unfortunately,
nope.
I'm going to have to take away your control of the IDS device for a bit, in lieu of showing you one more dimension.
Sure. Go for it, bro. Let me get out of here. Up here? Okay. That's an interesting piece of art. Okay.
Well, this is it. The last part of the trial. Good luck.
All right, so
careful. The blades are rather sharp.
I see that. Okay, so this one affects time. So it's actually slowing down time. Got it. I'm riding it. Oh, I died. Interesting. Oh, I was just supposed to drop down here. I get it. Okay.
Slow motion dimension. Rather self-explanatory, I think. I would move if I were you.
There we go. I'm still alive somehow. Things are going pretty well. The slow motion dimension isn't half bad.
I believe Ike stole these and hid them at one point. He's rather fond of shiny objects. Step off now!
Oh god. I made it. Holy piss. When he said now, I was already in the air. What? Where am I? What's going on? Am I going up or down? Oh. Well, that's not quite fair. What's going on there? It's shooting furniture up. I'm riding the front. Oh, I'm not riding the front. Am I right? I'm still kind of riding the front. I'm not riding. Oh, God. Dang it. I hate it whenever you know what to do, and yet you're still lose off. Now where am I? Okay. We have to wait a second for the stupid couch to come up. There we go. Oh, my. Really? Really? This is just pathetic. There we go. There we go. Where am I going? Ride more stinking, not couches. Love seats? What do you call these? Not love seats. Recliners? Whatever. Where am I going? Riding the safe. This is getting a little ridiculous, but at least we're getting somewhere. Where do I go? This way.
Okay, next.
Made it. Oh, jeez. Things are going well. Things are going well. I don't see a reason to jump off quite yet.
You should be able to fit through.
And I did.
Don't forget to breathe. It's an important aspect of life.
Well, that's pretty cool. I'm assuming
Splendid.
This is the end.
You've proved adept at overcoming rather obtuse obstacles. It's a shame that this is only a trial. I hate to admit it, but I think I could use your help.
I gotta admit, that was pretty cool. That was pretty neat. And the thing is, I do remember seeing some videos about it early on and thinking it was pretty neat, but you know, I just kind of forgot about it, kind of faded from my memory. And then I saw that it had come back, and I was like, oh, hey, that's that game. And I'm glad you guys recommended that I play this, because it's actually pretty cool. But thank you guys so much for watching, and be sure to join me next week for another exciting Demo Fridays. And if you have suggestions for a demo that you want to see done in the future, leave it in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next week.